channel, welcome to today's show. There was just a special meeting, ladies and gentlemen, 2024, of course, at the World Economic Forum, where all of these people who pretend to be elected, who were never elected in the first place, meet and collaborate, but the real word is conspire. They meet and they conspire against the civilians of the world. And of course, one of the big topics there happen to be the mind and the machine. How to mix the two. Go figure, right? Guess who was in front row, who was just smiling ear to ear, the guy who claims that we're all conspiracy nuts, of course, the same guy that got a pie smashed in his face.
Police and security guards in Belgium were put flat footed today by a cowardly sneak attack. One of the world's wealthiest men on the target was Microsoft Chairman Bill Gates arriving for a meeting with community leaders. Watch what happens when a team of hitmen meet him first with a pie in the face. Gates was momentarily and understandably shaken, but he was not injured. The squad piled on with two more pies, while one of them was rushing to the ground, but less than the others would reach the moment to run away. Gates went inside, wiped his face clean, and made no comment. He did went ahead with his scheduled meeting. No word on the motive for this attack.
It still doesn't seem to be able to get over it. He's so butthurt about it that he's literally trying to commit mass genocide. But Bill Gates was there, smiling ear to ear, of course, with Dr. Tedros, right? You know, a guy who's just a big pharma guy and a guy who's a tech guy. But don't connect the dots with them sitting next to each other, smiling. They care about everybody's health. And, of course, sitting in a room while we have people on stage talking about the mind and the machine and how we can mix the two. And then you have Bill Gates, who's supposed to be like the big computer whiz, and then you have a guy who's supposed to be giving us cures for diseases and medicine, right? Think about how that works. And I'll show you exactly how that works. I just want everyone to know, over on my other channel, Wake Up Call, if you haven't subscribed yet, it's linked below. Make sure you do that real quick. I have new content going up over there, two new videos over there as of this recording. And I'm going to be mixing my content between the two channels because we all know the more content you put out, the more suppressed it gets. So I just want to balance it out, and I want to build out as many channels as I can, get as much content out as I can while I can. Because that's the key, while I can. Because until, when the digital ID comes, when these things like I'm about to show you, mind and machine come, I'm not going to be here. So time is short with being able to get truth out. We see all the other stuff going on college campuses, all the stuff is pertaining to free speech and having to be held accountable for your speech in regards not to, well, if you go held accountable, if you say something to somebody's face, you get a fist fight. Well, that should be the way that it actually is handled, but held accountable means you'll go to prison for things that are against the government, and you have to have your digital ID to be able to talk online. So the channel is called Wake Up Call, and if you saw the video I did on earbuds, make sure you go over there and check out the last one I put up in regards to cell phones. They're putting out propaganda now in local affiliate markets about cell phone dangers, and it's important that everybody realizes why. It's not because the news is grown conscious and they want to tell you about cell phone radiation, the dangers of it. They're telling you about it because they're preparing the tech to get inside your body. And now I'll segue into this video. Make sure you sub to that channel, Wake Up Call, because this video is about just that. Mind and machine, right? Special meeting. They called it a special meeting in Davos. Now, why would they call it a special meeting? Because they don't get as much attention as the other meetings, so there won't be a lot of people out there talking about it because they didn't even know. And they just went and met again in Davos, you know, went and met again, or all the people of Davos, I should say, went and met again to collaborate, or I should say conspire, about what they want to do to humans. And let's roll out the tape here. Let me play for you. Mrs. or Mr. Farhani, who I've covered in the past, some of the stuff coming out of the mouth is unbelievable. I'll play some of the older clips if you don't remember as well. But let's start with what they're talking about. They're getting you prepared to get technology inside your body. I've talked about this forever. They don't want you to understand what this means. They want this to sound like gibberish to the common person, and it does. If you start thinking and paying attention, think about 6G, think about technology embedded in you, that just makes sense. And here is Mr. Miss Farhani, whatever, this demon, speaking about how we need to work on getting technology under the skin, and how are we going to be able to do that? And we need other ways, you know, other than a brain, you know, going and doing surgery on the brain, which, of course, they already know that they don't need to do that because they just actually did this neurological experiment on the entire world. But listen.
It depends on what we're talking about from what we're talking about neurotechnology. And I think a lot of it gets grouped together under a single umbrella. And it's useful to divide the world up between what is implanted neurotechnology neuro technology for therapeutic purposes, where there are a number of companies that have made extraordinary advances over the past few years in moving through clinical trials to be able to do things like potentially restore movement or to give people back self-determination who, for example, are quadriplegics or unable to communicate verbally or through eye movements to get those brain signals out and to be able to communicate with devices more directly. That is a limited subset, but some of them have moved to phase three clinical trials, and a lot of them are looking at how do they make these devices less invasive. Are there different mechanisms, miniaturization of the technology, or ways to get it into the brain in ways that are less traumatic from a surgery perspective or otherwise, and is it something that can go to scale? There are hundreds of thousands of people who stand to benefit from the benefits that that offers.
So when you hear this thing talk about, of course, I've mentioned this many times, they're using things to get people to think it's okay and it's safe, right? A poor person that has Parkinson's, they don't talk about why someone has Parkinson's. They're the reason that people have disabilities, because they dump chemicals on us every single day, aluminum, barium, as well as in our food. They're the reason that these diseases continue to spread like cancer, okay? That's a fact. But what they talk about is they want to play on your heartstrings. So if someone like me says that this is okay, they say, well, what about that poor person that has Parkinson's? And I would say to them, well, how did they get it? They won't answer that. They'll just roll their head and say, well, it's, disease, it's spread. They won't answer. They would just ignore it like they do any actual question. But unfortunately, nobody really ever asks them real questions, because the media that covers the World Economic Forum is all bought and controlled media that works for them. So they'll never have to answer that, why people get these diseases. But they'll tell you the solution for the disease they cause, because that's how problem reaction solution works, right? And of course, you're talking about how to get it inside of people's bodies. These poor people have all these diseases, what can we do? And also, how can we fast track it? How can we fast track it? Well, newsflash, if you're not paying attention, they just did fast track it. And remember, Elon Musk told us specifically how we can fast track the Neuralink inside of people's bodies. Not going to cut your head open like the movie Hannibal. Okay? They just ran an experiment to see how many people would sign up and go and do it, how many people they get scared of getting it, and how well it took inside of people's bodies just a few years ago, and it's still ongoing. But here's Elon talking about how it just go right into your bloodstream.
Something that's it's surgically inserted, or
I'm not even sure what it is. So we're already assigned it.
And you call them neural
layers.
Does that imply surgical insertion?
Not necessarily. You could go through the main artery system that provides a kind of rotating organ neurons. If neurons are very heavy in energy, so they need high blood flow, so you automatically withdraw those arteries and have a road network to your neurons.
So some kind of surgery,
right? Yes, but you could insert something, basically, and have it gets macabre. But
it sounds really easy. It
doesn't involve
surgery.
It doesn't involve chopping up and just getting your skull off or anything like that.
So does that sound like something that may ring a bell? You might say, well, wait a minute, right. People didn't just willingly sign up to participate with free will to do this themselves, even though the government did everything they can to make everybody go and get it. You didn't really have to go and get it, though. You just, a lot of people's lives are over. A lot of people lost their job. You can relate to a lot of the stuff that everybody went through, because obviously I went through about 75 hours during that period. But if you're trying to figure out, and you're new, right? Let's say hypothetically you're new and you found the channel, right? We're talking about man and machine, transhumanism, mixing iron and clay. This is mixing the technology that you're so accustomed to, the internet, aka the internet of bodies, right? Mixing that, your cell phone, all this, to being in you. And they're trying to subconsciously program you to be ready for this, and I've covered this so many times. But this is a clip of the same person, Farah Hadi, from 2 years ago. You guys said they went to 2023 in Davos. A very important thing that they go to, they openly talk about reading your brain, reading your thoughts, tracking your sleep, all things they prepared you with wearables, right? Tracking your footsteps, like, do you think, that's some neato idea that you're tracking your footsteps, counting how many calories you burn? They're conditioning you into, obviously, having this type of technology inside of your body so they can track you. They want to know how many steps you take as your carbon footprint. If you don't get how this works, I've explained it many times. There's lots of content on the website about it. But this is the clip that they played This is part of their seminar. That's laughable. It's laughable because it's insanity. Now we're letting, they're talking about the battle for your brain. That's what this meeting was about, okay? Your brain is yours. There shouldn't be a battle for your brain, but they're talking about a battle for your brain because they'll still tell you that people like me are crazy nuts because they don't want you to actually pay attention to what they're saying when they talk about brain metrics and being able to control your mind and being able to manipulate your mind. But this is what they rolled out a year ago, and they still are out in public talking about it. They still have been arrested for it. I would say that this is a crime against humanity.
Now we're going to do a little Q&A. Questions from the audience, and that'll be a wrap, and you'll leave enlightened and excited. So, first off, a video. It's thank you. See the future and understand a wonderful future where we can use brainwaves to fight crime, be more productive, and find love. Let's roll.
You're in this, even you can't believe how productive you've been. Your memo is finished, your inbox is under control, and you're feeling sharper than you have in a decade. Sensing your joy, your playlist shifts to your favorite song, sending chills up your spine as the music begins to play. You glance at the program running in the background on your computer screen and notice a now familiar sight that appears whenever you're overloaded with pleasure. Your theta brainwave activity decreasing in the temporal regions of your brain. You mentally move the cursor to the left and scroll through your brain data over the past few hours. You can see your stress levels rising as the deadline to finish your memo approached, causing a peak in your beta brainwave activity right before an alert popped up, telling you to take a brain break. But what's that unusual change in your brain activity when you're asleep? It started earlier in the month. You sent a text message to your doctor with a mental swipe of your cursor. Could you take a quick look at my brain data? Anything to worry about? Your mind starts to wander to the new colleague on your team, whom you know you shouldn't be daydreaming about, given the policy against intra-office romance, but you can't help fantasizing just a little. And then you start to worry that your boss will notice your amorous feelings when she checks your brain activity and shift your attention back to the present. You breathe a sigh of relief when the email she sent you later that day congratulates you on your break from the past quarter, which have earned you another performance bonus. You head home, jamming to the music, with your work-issued brain-sensing earbuds still in. When you arrive at work the next day, a somber cloud has fallen over the office. Along with emails, text messages, and GPS location data, the government has subpoenaed employees' brainwave data from the past year. They have compelling evidence that one of your co-workers has committed massive wire fraud. Now, they're looking for his co-conspirators. You discover they are looking for synchronized brain activity between your co-worker and the people he has been working with. While you know you're innocent of any crime, you've been secretly working with him on a new startup venture. Shaking, you move your earbuds.
What do you think? Is it a future you're ready for? You may be surprised to learn that it's a future that has already arrived. Everything in that video that you just saw is based on technology that is already here today. Artificial intelligence has enabled advances in decoding brain activity in ways that we never before thought possible. You've heard a lot about AI over the past few years here at Davos. It's been the talk of the hour. But I want to talk about it in a different way, which is the ability to decode brainwave activity. After all, what you think, what you feel, it's all just data. Data that in large patterns can be decoded using artificial intelligence. Consider this, the average person thinks thousands each day. As a person, you're hungry, agent. You're firing in your brain, emitting tidy electrical discharges. As a particular thought takes form, hundreds of thousands of neurons fire in characteristic patterns that can be decoded with EEG or electroencephalography and AI. powered devices. In fact, what you're seeing here is my brain activity while I'm wearing a simple device like the one on the right. We're not talking about implanted devices of the future. I'm talking about wearable devices that are like Fitbits for your brain.
So does that look like the kind of future you want? I talked about it when it came out. I don't need to rehash all the stuff from that video, but it's the same person talking about it. They're meeting at a special meeting 2024, and they're talking about the most important issue to them, which is how to mix man and machine, mind and machine, as Bill Gates sits in the front row, right? That's the thing that should just make people go, okay. You know, well, a lot of it should make people go, okay, what's going on here? Something's going on, right? Kind of like I talked about those bunkers, like Bill Gates is a bunker, Bezos, Zuckerberg, then you throw like the Kim Kardashians in the world where you start going, wait a minute, how do these people almost know something? They're millions of dollars. What do they know that I don't know? Well, they're the ones who are conspiring together to create an event so they can go and hide and you can die. That's pretty much what it is, right? But the other thing people should see, other than bunkers, people buying bunkers and be suspicious, is Bill Gates front and center, right? I mean, that sums it up. Bill Gates, he's a Microsoft guy, not the internet, right? Then suddenly he's obsessed with getting something inside people's bodies because he wants to, we gotta get people healthy and better. And this is pre the outbreak, right? He's obsessed with it, right? And then, of course, you get the guy who's the face of the organization who's gonna have the authority over getting it inside of people, right? Not to mention the fact, which I'll cover more on the website, they're covering it, the treaty that's about to get passed in May. We all have to keep an eye. Think, what does one have to do with the other? Oh, they just have money? Is that the common theme? There's a lot of people who just have money, right? See the mixing of technology and medicine, how they can get technology together. Think about it. I won't go into more detail because I'm not interested in getting a strike today, but we know that's inevitable anyway. So you have these people you didn't elect, and we have these problems occurring in the world that they're starting and creating and not solving on purpose. And then all of these things are going to lead to things like mixing medicine, right? Using meta machine, because ultimately this entire system, when they talk about the Great Reset, they talk about the fourth industrial revolution, okay, it's all run on technology, and you're going to be run just like some of the clips I've shown in the past, right, Stretch Armstrong, etc. You're going to be what's controlled, just like they showed you there, with the tech in your body, and people are like, that's neat, that's cool. I mean, look, if you think that's neat, cool, and you're ready to spend eternity in hell and put this stuff in your body, go ahead, have fun. But it's a very deceitful thing that they're doing. I'm trying my best to make people aware of it. So this is what they're concerned about. You know, hey, that's right. World leaders unelected, claim to be elected. They're all meeting together. One of the topics is, of course, how in the world can you get a brain chip inside of people? No one's like, oh, wait a minute. You think that they're just talking about a small percentage of people that have Parkinson's? So that's what the concern is. All the global leaders are getting together. They're sacrificing their carbon footprint and, of course, sacrificing to the others. Going to this event because they're thinking about the people that they've given Parkinson's disease to, or that they've given Alzheimer's to. They're the ones responsible for it. So they're getting together, and then they're playing on your emotions, making you think that that's what they care about, a small percentage of the population that has it. They're talking about it, global leaders, because they want to get this inside of you, and they're going to use things like Parkinson's, health problems, so that you think that that's what they're trying to do this for, and then we have to accept that. We can't question how demonic this is. We can't shut them down because it's, well, who are we to talk? This poor person has Parkinson's. How dare you? Maybe they want this tech, right? Instead of telling that poor person who has Parkinson's how he got Parkinson's, which is what we've all been screaming about for years. And these people still are walking the streets free. Pretty insane, right? So, man and machine, the mixing of iron and clay, might as well call the meeting at Davos, right? The mixing of iron and clay, the mind and the machine. Same difference, right? But nobody notices. And again, if you didn't subscribe to my other channel, Wake Up Call, it's very important that you do. This will probably get a strike for just mentioning, you know, that's something in the body, just even casually. They're still pretty buttered about people actually being wise to their plans. But remember, you gotta be as wise as a serpent and as innocent as does. And I tell people, you gotta be new videos up over there. This isn't a channel, the other one that I'm gonna be putting up old stuff. I might mix them in the future, I don't know. They don't let you upload old content anymore. I guess, you know, when they've taken channels out of the past, they put that through the system, and it's in the system so that it detects it. I get this reuse thing all the time if I try to re-upload my older content. So it's kind of a nightmare. They see double dual content, things like that out there. But it's going to be new content. It's going to be live streams. It's going to be a lot over there. I'm going to be building out multiple channels at once, so stay up to date now. Make sure you sub, and thank everybody for being here. Hope you all do well. God bless you and your families, as always.
every industry needs project managers, and a Google Career Certificate can help you get the skills to get the job. You'll learn project planning, budgeting, industry standard software, and the latest project management methodologies, all taught by
this week's Dark Side of the Ring.